Good day, children. Under the study of continents, we had completed Australia in our last video. Children, do you know which continent is a land of many cultures and countless decades of rich heritage and history? The place where the entire Western civilization came into existence. A continent that still mystifies and fascinates travelers and researchers all around the world. Let's have a sneak peek into the magical next door neighbor of Asia. Europe is the second smallest continent after Australia. The continent of Europe is only 3 times the size of India, but it has the 3rd largest population amongst all the continents after Asia and Africa. The combined landmass of Europe and Asia is called Eurasia. Europe is derived its name from Europa. Europa was the daughter of Phoenix in Greek mythology, and from Arab, the Phoenician word for sunset. Thus, the literal meaning of Europe is the land of setting sun. Europe has been a center of great cultural and economic achievement since the beginning on account of the ancient Greek and Roman civilizations, which made lasting contribution to fine arts, philosophy, literature, science, and government to the Renaissance. The Renaissance, which began in the 14th century and was a period of great achievement for artists and architects. It was a time of great prosperity, and it also brought a great change in Europe. From the age of exploration, leading to discovery of new land and voyages to distant places of the earth, to the Industrial Revolution that led to the development of modern industry. The Industrial Revolution began in the 18th century and was largely responsible for modernizing Europe. Location. Europe lies totally in the North temperate zone. A small portion of the continent extends beyond the Arctic Circle in the polar region. To its east, it is joined to the continent of Asia. Europe looks like a peninsula in the west. Latitudinal extent is 35 degree north to 73 degree north latitudes. Longitudinal extent of Europe, 25 degree west to 65 degree east. The prime meridian, or the 0 degree longitude, passes through the London Observatory Center at Greenwich. Size. Total area of Europe is 10,180,000 square kilometer, inclusive of European Russia. Europe continent comprises 6.8% Earth's total land and 2% of Earth's surface. Europe is called peninsula because it is bounded by water bodies on all 3 sides. To its north lies the Arctic. To its west is the Atlantic Ocean, and the Mediterranean Sea lies to its south. In the east, it is bounded by the Ural Mountains, which separates Europe from Asia. In southeast, Caspian Sea and the Caucasus Mountain, Strait of Gibraltar separates Europe from Africa. Coastline. Europe has a long and indented coastline, which is not smooth and have cuts. There are many headlands jutting into the sea, forming small peninsulas. Hence, Europe has been given name of Peninsula of Peninsulas. Europe's intended coastline consists of many inland seas, deep bays and gulfs. It has numerous natural harbors in Europe. Recapitulation. So children, today we have understood about Europe under history, location. The subdivision under location we included latitudinal and longitudinal extent, size, boundaries and coastline of Europe. Children, till the time you will get next video, find out how many are the total countries of Europe and which is the largest and smallest country in Europe. Thank you, children.